Good morning, everyone. I am Dr. Neeraj Gupta. So let's start with the steady state error for a non-unity feedback system. Previously, what we have discussed is the unity feedback system, that in the feedback we have no block attached to it. But in this case, we have some value. So the way in which it is considered is different as compared to the this unity feedback system. So the control system often do not have unity feedback because of the compensation used to improve the performance or because of the physical model of the system. That is, we actually this feedback we are using for compensation, and because of that we can't say that we have this unity feedback system. The feedback path can be a pure gain other than the unity or have some dynamic representation. Now, a general feedback system showing the input transducer, that is this one, input transducer, that is G1, and the controller, that is G2, and the feedback, that is H1, is shown here. So it is a non-unity feedback system. Now, our main idea is that we want to convert this non-unity feedback system into unity feedback system. Now pushing this input transducer, that is G1, to this inside this, that is after the summing junction, we get a non-unity feedback system. That is, we get a non-unity feedback system. That is, this input transducer, that is G1, is placed here after the summing point, and finally we are getting this. That is, in the transfer function is GS, and this feedback is HS. Now this GS, when we place this GS after the summing point, then GS is equal to G1S into G2S. That is, we have placed after the summing point, that we have discussed in the analysis of this block diagrams. Then, since this HS, we have placed this G1 with the G2 here, okay, we have placed G1 here, G2, but also since H1 is impacted by placing here G1, so as a result, what we do for this HS, what we do, this HS is equal to, it is equals to H1S divided by GS. So if this is H1S divided by GS and this is G1 into G2, so H1 simply, that is, G1S, then when we multiply it with G1S, finally we are getting the signal as H1S. So that we have discussed in this block diagram reduction techniques. Now one more point is there, that unlike the unity feedback system, in a unity feedback system, the error is actually the difference between the input and the output. That is, in a unity feedback system, if no HS is there, then error is simply the difference between this and this, okay, input and the output. So whatever desired output and what is the actual output, we get the error out of that. However, this block is there, so we cannot have this in this case for a non-unity feedback system. So for this case, we call a signal at the output of the summing junction the actuating signal. That is, for this case, we call the signal at the output of the summing junction, that is the actuating signal in this case. Now let us suppose that if we have this summing, we have no feedback is there in the system, that is sorry, only unity feedback is there in the system, then simply the error is the difference between this RT and the CT. So what we do, we first make the system such that it is the unity feedback system, so for the to make the calculations easy. Now, to make this system, to convert this system into the unity feedback system, what we do, we add minus 1 and the plus 1 to this system, that is, it is nullified. So we add minus 1 here and plus 1 here, that is unity gain and minus unity gain here. Now now again with this, we combine this HS and this one. When we combine HS and this one, finally we are getting HS minus 1, as we have read in the in case of this block diagram reduction, that when we have the signals at the summing point, then these are added, so HS minus 1. So finally we are having GS HS minus 1 and this unity. And finally what we do, since this is the feedback loop, internal feedback loop, so we combine this internal feedback loop and finally we obtain this, that is GS divided by 1 plus GS HS minus GS. So it is a unity feedback system. And finally, from this diagram, you will see that ES is equals to the difference between input, that is RS minus CS, because we have the unity feedback here. So what we have done, we have the non-unity feedback system, we try to convert it into unity feedback system. Here one example is there, in which the concepts of steady state error, system type, static error constants for a non-unity feedback system are clear. So we have to find the steady state error for the non-unity feedback system. Now the problem statement is that for the system shown in the figure, find the system type, the appropriate error constant associated with the system type, and the steady state error for the unit step input. Assume the input and the output units are the same. One condition is also there, that the inputs and output units must be same. Now to solve this, the first case is that we have to find the stability, that is root criteria, that we can discuss after some time. Also in this case, we can say that since it's a non-unity feedback system, so in this case the error, that is EA, is not the difference between RS and the CS, as we have discussed in the unity feedback case. Now first step in solving the problem is to convert the system into the system that we have discussed earlier, that is this one, that we have to convert the system in this form, and after that we can find out different things that is a steady state error for a unit step input or whatever is required in this case. So also one more point, that like seeing this system, that it has the denominator S, that is S is there in the denominator, and S raised to power N, and N is equals to 1 in this case, and so it is a type 1. So it is not the case here, because that was the case for a unity feedback system. So first of all, we have to find the equivalent value of the S. After finding the equivalent value of S for a this unity feedback system, we even came to know that what type of system it is. Now GS in this case is given by this one, then HS is equals to this one. Now finally, whatever we have done in the previous example, so G equivalent equal to GS divided by 1 plus GS HS minus GS, that is, like in this case we have found the equivalent. Now after that, from this we came to know that there is no S in the denominator, that is S raised to power that is 0, or we can say that n is 0 in this case, so it is a type 0 system. No pair integration is there, that is no 1 by s term is there in frequency domain, and no integration is there in the time domain. Now for that, as we have discussed the table, that for type 0 systems, if no pair integration is there, so for a type 0 system, if we have the step input, then this value is constant, so we have to find the value of this Kp, as we have discussed in the problem. Now Kp is given by this, so finally we got minus 5/4, and error at infinite is given by 1 divided by 1 plus Kp is equals to minus 4. Now negative value of this steady state error means that the output step is larger than the input step, that is the output is larger than the input. If the input is like that, then the output is here. Okay. Now we have considered previously, we have considered the non-unity feedback system. Now we consider the disturbance also in this case. So we have the non-unity feedback system and disturbance also in this case. Now we derive a general equation for the steady state error and determine the parameters of the system for error. Now the steady state, as we have done in the previous case, where the feedback, where unity feedback was there, solving that, as we have done in the previous case, solving that in terms of RS and DS, we get these two equations, and using the final value theorem, we get these two equations in which there is a relationship between this error ES and RS of the first equation, and the relationship between ES and DS, that is disturbance of the second equation. Now, as we have discussed in the previous case, we have taken the disturbance equals to unit step, that is 1 by s. So same is taken here also. That is disturbance in this case is unit step disturbance. That is ds in this case is 1 by s. So we got this expression. Okay. Now for the error to be 0, for this to be 0, so these two equations must be equal to 0. That for steady state error to be 0, these two equations must be equals to 0. Okay, so when these two equations are 0, then first equation is given by this and the second equation is this. Okay, so we have the two equations, that is for 0 error, this condition and this condition, first one and second one, condition must be satisfied. Now these conditions are satisfied under these some conditions, that is if this G1, if the system is stable, that is first condition is that system must be stable. The system must be stable, so first condition is that. Second condition is that G2 must be of type 2, that is G2 must be of type 0 system. Type 0 system, that is no integrations are there in that. And third one, that is HS is also type 0 system, that is no integration, pure integration is there, with the DC gain of unity, with the DC gain of unity. Okay, and final most important condition is that G1 is a type 1 system, that is G1S is a type 1 system. Now these conditions are satisfied if these conditions are satisfied if these conditions are satisfied. Now, in this case, we see that if G1 is a type 1 system, that is one integration is there in there. So we have for a one integration, we have when S tends to 0, then in the this term becomes infinite and this divided by infinite is equals to 0. Okay, 1 divided by infinite, this some value divided by infinite equal to 0. So this is satisfied. And also in this case also, when this G1 is a type 1 system, then in that very case, here in the denominator we got S, and in the here we got S, and here also we get in the denominator we will have the S, and in this cells also in the denominator we have S. So S is divisible by S, and finally we are getting this equation, that is limit of G1S into G2S, S plus G1S, G2S, and HS is unity in this case. And also when S tends to 0, finally it will cancel out and we are getting the 1. So this condition must be satisfied. Also one more point, that there is no restriction that the input and the output units, that is there is no restriction that the input and the output units, input and the output units be same, since we are finding the steady state difference between the signals at the summing junction, which do have the same units. Now, finally, the steady state actuating signal is equals to this. Okay, so this is the steady state actuating signal that we have found out, that is, it is given by limit of S RS G1S divided by 1 plus G2S into H1S limit of S tends to 0. Okay. So we have found the steady state error signal or the actuating signal. Now we will discuss with a small example. Now we have to find the steady state actuating signal of the system as shown in the figure for a unit step input. That is, input in this case is 1 by S. So repeat it for unit ramp input also. Okay, now we obtained the derivation of this, that is EA infinite, that is steady state actuating signal, is given by this expression. So putting the value, all the value in that, and we get this for a unit step input. This steady state actuating signal is equals to 0, and for a unit ramp input, when we put the unit ramp in that, we get the steady state error or the actuating signal in this case is 1 divided by 2. Now this problem that you have to do at your own end, you have to find the steady state error for a unit step input given this non-unity feedback system. Okay, and repeat this for unit ramp input. Assume input and output units to be same, that units of input and output must be same in this case. And second part, find the steady state actuating signal EA for a unit step input given the non-unity feedback system. Now in the first case, you have to find the steady state error with unit step input 1 by S, that is with the unit step input, and the system in this case is non-unity feedback system. And second is, you have to find the steady state actuating signal EA okay, for a unit step input given the non-unity feedback system. So you have to do at your own end. So in this case, we applied the steady state error analysis to non-unity feedback system. When non-unity feedback system is present, the actuating signal is not the actual error or difference between the input and the output that we have discussed. Okay. So when non-feedback system is there, then this is not the difference between this RS and CS. With non-unity feedback system, we may choose, that is, either find the steady state error for a system where input and output units are same. That is, find the steady state error for the system where input and output units are same. That is, input and output units are same. And in the second case, find the steady state actuating signal. Okay. So with the non-unity feedback system, we may choose from these two. That is, find the steady state actuating signal. So also we have derived the expression for the steady state error for non-unity feedback system with disturbance also. And we use this equation to determine the attributes of the subsystem so that there was zero error for step input and step disturbances. Now come to sensitivity. Now during the design process, the engineer may want to consider the extent to which the changes in the system parameters affect the behavior of the system. That is, what are the changes in the system parameters which affect the behavior of the system? Ideally, the parameter changes due to heat, that is, parameter changes due to the heat or other causes should not appreciably affect the system performance. The degree to which changes affect the system parameters and the performance, the degree to which the changes in system parameters, changes, the degree to which changes in system parameters affects the system transfer function, that is, system transfer function and the performance, and the performance is called the sensitivity of the system. It is called the sensitivity, that is, the degree to which the changes in the system parameters affect the system transfer function and hence performance is called the sensitivity of the system. A system with zero sensitivity, if the sensitivity is zero, is the ideal system. Greater with the value of sensitivity, the less desirable the effect of the parameter change. Now let us consider a function f. Let f is equals to k divided by k plus a. Okay. And if k equals to 10, if k equals to 10 and a equals to 100, then in that very case, the value of f is equals to 0.091. Okay. Now, if a parameter triples, let us suppose that if a equals to 300, then the value of f is equals to value of f is equals to 0.032. Okay. Now from this you will see that the fractional change in the parameter a, that is, the change in the parameter a is 300 divided by 100 divided by 100. So this is the fractional change in the parameter A, that is 2%, that is 200% change, yields the change in function of, that is 0.032 minus 0.091 divided by 0.091, and which is equals to minus 0.65, that is, which is equals to this 0.65, that is 65%. Okay, so a fractional change in the parameter A yields the change in the function F, that is this one, 65%. Thus the function F has reduced sensitivity to changes in parameter A. So from this you will see it is 200% and this is 65%. So function F has reduced sensitivity to changes in the parameter A, this one. Now as we proceed, we will see that another advantage of the feedback system is that it reduced the sensitivity of parameter changes. That is, the feedback system reduces the sensitivity to parameter changes. That is an important part of the feedback system, that is, sensitivity is reduced. Now the definition of sensitivity is, it is the ratio of fractional change in the function, that is the ratio of the fractional change in the function to the fractional change in the parameter as the fractional change in the parameter approaches zero. That is the ratio of fractional change in the parameter function to the fractional change in the parameter as the fractional change in the parameter approaches zero. That is, fractional change in the function is del f divided by f, and change in the parameter is del f del p divided by p, and finally we are getting this equation, and which reduces to this one, that is, sensitivity is equals to p del f divided by f del p. Now let us discuss a small problem. In this case, we have to calculate the sensitivity. We have to calculate the sensitivity of this closed loop transfer function to changes in the parameter A, to the changes in parameter A. Okay, now it is actually a unity feedback system. So first we have to find the closed loop transfer function. Closed loop transfer function can be obtained as GS divided by 1 plus HS GS, and finally in this case the closed loop transfer function is equals to, after calculation, TS is equals to K divided by S square plus AS plus K. Okay, so we know the sensitivity. Now sensitivity can be found out by this equation that we have discussed, that is, the change in fractional change in the function to the fractional change in the parameter, this one. So in this case the parameter is A, so the parameter in this case is this, and function in this case is T. Finally A divided by T, so T in this case is equals to K divided by S square plus AS plus K, and the derivative of T with respect to A, it is given, it is equals to minus KS divided by
s square plus as plus k whole square. And finally, the final equation that we are getting is minus as divided by minus as divided by s square plus as plus k. Okay. Now from this we can say, from this equation we can conclude that for any value of s, an increase in the value of the k will reduce the sensitivity of this closed loop transfer function to changes in parameter a. That is, for a value of s, if k increases, this sensitivity decreases, closed loop sensitivity decreases to the changes in the parameter a. Okay. Now for the same system, we have to calculate the sensitivity of steady state error with the ramp input. So we have to calculate in this case the sensitivity of steady state error to changes in the parameter k, to the changes in parameter k with and parameter a. That is, we have to find the sensitivity of steady state error to changes in parameter k and changes in parameter a with the ramp input. Now steady state error for the system with the ramp input, as we have already seen in the previous module, it is equals to 1 divided by kv, and kv can be calculated as limit of s gs as s tends to 0, which is coming out to be a divided by k. Now the sensitivity of e infinite, this sensitivity of this to changes in parameter a, we have to found out that in this case the change in parameter is a. Now finally our equation for this sensitivity would be, that is, sensitivity of this change in the parameter a. Okay, e a. So a del e divided by e del a. So parameter change is, in this case, is a. And finally we are getting a divided by a by k into 1 by k, which is coming out to be 1. Now second, we have to find this sensitivity with the changes in the parameter k. So the change is there in the parameter k, so finally the sensitivity equation becomes k del e divided by e del k. In the first it was a, now second it was k, it is k. Now finally this k divided by e, it is given by k divided by a by k, and along with that minus a into k square, and finally we are getting minus 1. Now from this we analyze that changes in this parameter, either changes in the parameter k or the a, are directly reflected in this, and there is no reduction or increase in the sensitivity. Also we have the negative sign here. It indicates that a decrease in E infinity, that is decrease in this steady state error for an increase in K. So both of the results could have been found directly also. However, we have done with this method. Okay. Now in this case we have to find the steady state error to the changes in the parameter k, to the changes in parameter k and parameter a,
for a system with step input. So in this case we have input as the step input. Now from the previous table, the steady state error is, since it's a type 0 system, from here we can see, so it is a type 0 system, and the steady state error for this system is equals to, that is E infinity equals to 1 divided by 1 plus Kp. It has only one constant term, that is Kp, which is equals to 1 divided by 1 plus K divided by AB, which is equals to AB divided by AB plus K. So this is the value of this steady state error. Now the sensitivity of this steady state error to changes in the parameter A, that is sensitivity of this steady state error to the changes in the parameter A, which is equals to, that is, that we have discussed earlier also, that is A divided by E and del E divided by del A. Okay, now in this case it is A, so A divided by AB divided by AB plus K, then we have into, when we differentiate it, AB plus K, AB plus K into B minus AB square divided by AB plus K square, and finally we are getting K divided by AB plus K. So this is sensitivity when the A changes, that is sensitivity to the changes in the parameter A. Now in the second case we have to find the sensitivity with the change in parameter K, that is we have to find the sensitivity with the change in parameter K. In this case the expression would be K divided by E del E divided by del K, which is equals to K divided by AB divided by AB plus K into minus AB divided by AB plus K square, and finally we are getting final result as minus K divided by AB plus K. Okay, so it is with respect to K and with respect to A, it is erased it, K divided by, so for this equation, so you can we can say that sensitivity to the changes in parameter K and changes in the parameter A is less than unity for positive A and B, that is for the positive value of A and B, the sensitivity is less than unity. So we can say that feedback in this case yields the reduced sensitivity to the variation in both the parameters. So feedback will reduce the sensitivity to the variation in both the parameters. So this is a problem for you. This is a system, type 0 system. So you have to find the sensitivity of steady state, sensitivity of steady state error to changes in K, to changes in K, here K is here. So you have to find the sensitivity of steady state error to the changes in K for the system. So you have to find the sensitivity of steady state error to the changes in K in this case. Now what we have done in this module, we have studied this steady state error for a non-unity feedback system, and then we convert this non-unity feedback system into this unity feedback system. Then steady state, we have to do, we have also done some problems related to that. Then non-unity feedback system with the disturbances, we have discussed that, and find out the actuating signal in that very case, and also do some and also have done some problems related to that. And after that we have done the problems of steady state error problems. As for finding the steady state error and actuating signal. After that, we discussed about the sensitivity of the system, that how to find the sensitivity of the system, which is the fractional change in the function to the fractional change in the parameter. We have derived the formula for that, and after that we have done some problems related to that. That is, we have to calculate the sensitivity to the changes in the parameter A. Then sensitivity, that is, we have also calculated the sensitivity for a ramp input with the change in parameter K and A, and sensitivity for a steady state error with step input with the change in K and A, and finally this is at your end that you have to do. So this is about this error chapter. And in the next chapter, we can start about this stability part. Hope this you can get insight about this chapter, that how we can calculate and what are the specifications that are there in this case. So next we will start with the stability part. Thank you.